Born on the planet Naboo in 82 BBY, Palpatine was the son of a Naboo royal named Kosinga. Palpatine was considered an outcast among his family due to his innate cunning and intelligence, which led him to conspire against his father's bid for the Naboo throne. These actions brought him to the attention of a mune named Hugo Damask, who in reality was the Dark Lord of the Sith, Darth Plagueis. Recognizing the boy's latent force powers and hatred for his father, Plagueis manipulated Palpatine into murdering his own parents. Palpatine then went on to train under Plagueis, taking the name Darth Sidious. Through political skill and manipulation, Sidious, with his disguise as Palpatine, became Senator of Naboo and eventually Supreme Chancellor of the Republic, while at the same time becoming more and more versed in the ways of the dark side. Palpatine eventually murdered his master, taking the title Master of the Sith for himself. Over the years, Sidious instigated events such as the Inchori Crisis and the Trade Federation invasion that slowly weakened the Jedi Order and turned most of the Senate to his side, up until his final grand scheme, which was the breakout of the Clone Wars. With him as Chancellor managing the Republic and his apprentice Dooku managing the Separatists, slowly but surely the galaxy began to wither. Palpatine eventually revealed himself to Anakin Skywalker in 19 BBY, who he intended to be his ultimate apprentice. Anakin revealed this information to the few Jedi Masters who were still left at the Jedi Temple, one of which was Mace Windu, who then went on an attempt to arrest the Sith Lord. Sidious, finally dropping his charade, quickly dispatched the three other Masters, but was briefly subdued by Windu. Unfortunately, before the final blow was struck, Anakin Skywalker saved Sidious, and the young Jedi's conversion was complete. Bestowing upon Anakin the title Darth Vader, Sidious then went on to execute Order 66, which then resulted in the systematic slaughter of most of the Jedi Order. Following that, Palpatine transformed the Galactic Republic into the Galactic Empire, which, followed by a failed attempt to destroy the Emperor by Grandmaster Yoda, Palpatine had brought the Sith imperative to fruition. It wasn't until 4 ABY that Palpatine's plans were thwarted by Luke Skywalker and the newly redeemed Anakin Skywalker, which resulted in Palpatine being thrown into the Death Star 2's reactor. However, this wasn't the end for the Dark Lord, as he was able to preserve his spirit in several clone bodies, which he used to wage war on the Alliance once more. It wasn't until Palpatine attempted to steal the body of the young Anakin Solo that the Sith Lord's spirit was finally banished to the afterlife for good. Palpatine was in many ways the major villain of the Star Wars franchise, and his achievements and impacts on the galaxy will likely continue to be felt till the end of time. Born in 5113 BBY on a planet in the ancient Sith Empire, Tenebri was the son of a Sith pureblood. Tenebri eventually killed his stepfather at the age of 6 by snapping his neck with the Force. This action brought him to the attention of his true father, who was the Sith Lord Drumoth, who began training the boy in the ways of the Sith. After killing his master, Tenebri approached the Sith Council, where the then Dark Lord of the Sith, Marco Ragnos, took him as a full apprentice. Downing the name Darth Vitiate, he became one of the leading members of the Sith Order and ruled his home planet with an iron grip. However, this was not to last, as following the death of Ragnos and the Great Hyperspace War, Vitiate was forced into exile. Desperate for revenge on the Republic and the Jedi Order, as well as the utter annihilation of all life in the galaxy, Vitiate took the title of Sith Emperor and built his own empire with the intent of crushing the Republic and the Jedi Order on Dromund Kaas. Determined not to die, Vitiate used a combination of Sith magic and rituals to preserve his spirit, with his ultimate goal being total immortality. This obsession caused the Emperor to rule from the shadows, with his appointed Dark Council managing the Empire. However, it wasn't until the two Jedi Knights, Revan and Alec, attempted to destroy the Emperor that Vitiate put his plans into motion. Defeating and brainwashing Revan and Alec to act as scapegoats for the Sith, Vitiate rallied his forces after defeating and imprisoning the redeemed Revan, launched a full-scale assault on the Jedi Order and the Republic. The war that followed lasted for many years, with both the Jedi Order and the Republic being pushed to the brink. It wasn't until the man who became known as the Hero of Tython confronted and defeated Vitiate that the war was brought to an end. However, it was revealed that Vitiate was able to preserve his weakened spirit and continued his quest for immortality. However, it was not to be, as it was revealed in the Darth Plagueis novel that Vitiate eventually did die. Permanently. Vitiate is remembered for being one of the building blocks of the Sith Order, and his power and secrets have been revered by Sith through the generations. First, we will compare them physically. Palpatine is an 82-year-old human male and isn't exactly what I'd call in the prime of his physical state. Due to his enormous power, he has suffered some dark side degradation, such as pale skin and yellow eyes. However, even with that, Palpatine was still able to keep up with much younger combatants, and his senses and reflexes are still perfectly in tune. Palpatine was also a capable unarmed combatant, being trained by Plagueis to near perfection in Terras Kaze, which is the art of force-imbued martial arts. These skills allow Palpatine to easily smash skulls and windpipes, and he is able to pull off some acrobatics you may not expect from him. Overall, he may look old and deformed, but appearances can be deceiving. Vitiate's current body is a member of the Sith species, and he himself is 1,472 years old. He too has suffered massive dark side degradation, with almost translucent skin and eyes that were described as black as space. However, while he's obviously insane, his senses and his reflexes still appear to be intact. Although Sith species are naturally tougher than humans, he is still extremely old and well past his physical prime. As far as physical ability goes, neither Palpatine or Vitiate have a definitive edge over one another, as they both suffer from varying levels of degradation, and although Palpatine's martial arts may give him an edge, I can't imagine it would come to play in a battle like this. With that said, I declare them equal in terms of physical ability. Now we compare them as martial artists and lightsaber duelists. Darth Sidious was without a doubt one of the greatest duelists of his era. And the irony of that is that Sidious only considered his use of the lightsaber as a way to mock the Jedi, signifying his preference for the Force. However, it's obvious only the very best could stand against him in a duel. Although Palpatine has studied every aspect of Jedi fighting and is stated to be a master of all seven forms of lightsaber dueling, after careful observation and study, I've been able to pin down his preferred styles, them being Form 1, Chi Cho, Form 4, Ataru, Form 6, Naiman, and Form 7, Juyo. Form 1 is all about letting the flow of battle work with you, and is very random and precise. Although it is terrible against single opponents, it is excellent against multiple enemies, evidented by Palpatine's ability to take on multiple Jedi at once. Form 4, Ataru, is the most physically demanding of all lightsaber styles, and utilizes a lot of jumps, flips, and kicks, as demonstrated with his battle with Yoda. Form 6, Naiman, is a style that takes bits from all styles, as shown by Palpatine constantly changing styles in the middle of battle. It is also a gateway for Jar-Kai dual-blade fencing, which Palpatine demonstrated skillfully during his battle with Darth Maul and his brother Savage Opress. Form 7, Juyo, is very aggressive, and relies on completely overpowering your enemy, demonstrated by Palpatine often lashing out in anger and trying to completely demolish his opponent. Overall, Palpatine is a complete powerhouse with a wide range of styles that make him completely unpredictable and able to deal with a wide variety of situations. Emperor Vitiate was often said to prefer only relying on his force abilities over his dueling. However, this makes sense as he grew up in an era that was focused on Sith sorcery and magic, rather than swordplay. That being said though, Vitiate was more than willing to draw his lightsaber if necessary, rather than relying solely on his force abilities. Due to the era he was trained in, and judging by how he uses his lightsaber, it is likely Vitiate specializes in Form 7, Juyo. As I said before, very aggressive and powerful, relying on completely overpowering your enemy by lashing out. However, Vitiate's skills with the blade are clearly lacking, as even when he's dueling, he relies heavily on force ability rather than his martial ability. This preference is obvious, as when during their duel, the Hero of Tython was able to easily defeat Vitiate once their lightsabers were drawn, forcing the Emperor to resort to his force abilities. Honestly, I'm surprised he even uses a lightsaber, as he is so clearly a force user. I don't think it's a surprise who's the superior duelist. Palpatine has a much wider range of styles and skills and has proven himself to be an absolute master duelist. Vitiate, by contrast, has turned all his attention inward, focusing entirely on his force abilities while Palpatine has a more balanced skill set. Let me put this into perspective, people. Only 6 Jedi have challenged Sidious directly to a duel. Only 3 of them lasted more than 1 minute. Only 2 of them came out of it with their lives. And only one of them was actually able to defeat him. Overall, it's better to concentrate on multiple abilities than just be really good at one, as it gives you the ability to deal with a wider range of threats, and because of this, Palpatine gets the edge as a lightsaber duelist. Now we compare their force abilities. Darth Sidious was one of the most powerful force users in galactic history, and his immersion in the dark side was so great that he was often referred to simply as the Shadow. Due to Darth Plagueis' training and the philosophy of the Rule of Two studying every aspect of Jedi lore, Palpatine had a wide variety of Force abilities at his disposal, all of which were taken to the nth degree. Basically put, his Force pushes and shoves were able to send incredibly huge objects hurtling through the air, as he was able to grab and hurdle the pods in the Senate with ease. Palpatine's speed was also highly advanced, as during his duel with Windu, he was said to be fading in and out of existence. He was even able to catch Yoda and Luke Skywalker off guard with powerful bursts of speed during their respective duels. Palpatine also has great skill with Tutuminus and can deflect lightning and other projectiles with ease. He also has skills with the Jedi Mind Trick, Force Illusion, Battle Meditation, and the Healing Arts. However, the true power of Sidious lies in his mastery of the dark side. Sidious was an absolute master of Force lightning and seemed to favor it heavily, and has been shown to generate lightning so powerful that the victim was literally disintegrated. He has also used it in conjunction with Force Wave to destroy entire battalions. He is also capable of Force Choke and has mastered the art of Spirit Transfer and can transmute his spirit into the body of clones if necessary. Palpatine also has skill with midichlorian manipulation and can use it to heal wounds and create ripples in the Force. However, he had not mastered this ability to the extent of his master and can't bring the dead back to life or will someone to die. Palpatine has also shown some skill in Sith sorcery, but his knowledge in this field is not often explored. The absolute pinnacle of Palpatine's powers was his mastery of Force Storm. He was able to channel the dark side energies that swirl around all life to create massive storms of power, so devastating that he sometimes had trouble keeping it under control. During his battle with Luke, he used this ability to destroy an entire legion of Alliance ships, and he has even been said to use it to annihilate entire civilizations. However, this ability requires lengthy concentration, not something he would often have time to do in a heated battle. Emperor Vitiate was feared far and wide for his mastery of the Force, and many of his subjects were terrified of his mere presence. His Force pushes and shoves could send an entire group of people flying through the air, and his Force speed was enough to catch many of his victims unawares. He is also capable of Tutuminus and can use it to deflect Force lightning and other projectiles. He is also highly skilled in the Jedi Mind Trick and routinely brainwashes beings into becoming his subjects, as well as feeding on their own hatred. However, like Palpatine, Vitiate's true strength lies in his mastery of the dark side. He is very skilled in Force lightning and is able to chain it through multiple targets. Interestingly enough, Vitiate has also been shown to generate black Force lightning as opposed to the usual blue or purple. However, if you've seen my Force lightning description video, you'll know that the color doesn't make a difference in power. Vitiate was also an absolute master of spirit transfer and would divide his spirit among multiple bodies in order to survive. However, this ability really doesn't have much in terms of combative application, and it is mainly a survival tool. The pinnacle of Vitiate's power, however, was his mastery of Sith sorcery. Basically, Vitiate was Naga Sadao and Ludo Koresh taken to the nth degree. He is able to generate illusions of himself so real that they could actually cause harm. He can use sorcery to alter perception and cloud the minds of others, and he can use alchemy gauntlets to generate minor force blasts. Vitiate's greatest achievement, though, was when he used his sorcery to drain an entire planet of life. However, this was only done through the use of a complex ritual that required the cooperation of dozens of Sith Lords, as well as weeks of preparation and augmentation. Like Naga Sadao destroying a sun, it is not something he could just do on command. However, I believe Vitiate's powers have been extremely exaggerated, as most of his sorcery feats were accomplished only through rituals and sacrifices, not his own power. He grew up in an age where sorcery was the main focus and little else, meaning his own natural powers weren't the main focus. Although he lived hundreds of years longer than his peers, his focus the whole time was his quest for immortality and little else. Even Vitiate himself was borderline paranoid of the return of Naga Sadao, and I think that really says something about his abilities. While I don't outright doubt his abilities, when looking at his achievements, I think it's safe to say that Vitiate couldn't have been exponentially stronger in the Force than Naga Sadao or Exar Kun. However, Vitiate was still a fearsome threat, and his powers were still highly advanced for what they were. When comparing these two, it really comes down to the debate of natural power versus non-natural power. One time over Skype, GreyJedi91, Jarl Poof for all you veteran subscribers of his, and I talked about this very subject, and he said something that I think perfectly sums up this debate. But instead of me telling you what he said, how about I have him tell you himself? Take it away, dude.
As far as I'm concerned, Force potential tends to fall within two distinct branches, naturally gifted and unnaturally empowered. And in the case of the latter category, there are three different subclasses that I have defined for myself: temporary augmentation, Force anomalies, and permanent alteration. Beings like Nagasada with his meditation sphere, or Hazen with his numerous talismans, greatly increased their potential in the Force through artificial means. Then of course we have Force anomalies. Now these are the rarest sort. These are beings with an indeterminate level of Force potential, and are thus capable of feats far beyond the realm of possibility for natural Force wielders. Anakin Skywalker and his most immediate descendants, for example, and then of course beings like the Ones. These are beings I would class as Force anomalies. As far as I'm concerned, Emperor Vitiate was the product of permanent alteration, a term I've defined for myself. Beings who fall into this category of unnaturally increased power have gained their strength in the Force by changing their very nature, making them far more powerful than they were ever meant to be. Though, more often than not, a heavy toll is usually exacted upon these characters in return. Beings like this, of course, would include figures like Darth Nihilus, Darth Sion, and Emperor Vitiate, who achieved his immortality through use of a ritual which caused extreme and unending agony. Vitiate drew in the power of thousands of other Sith in order to achieve what he achieved throughout his life. To be sure, he was a force to be reckoned with, but he was also representative of the ancient ways of the Sith. Augmentation through rituals, alchemy, and talismans, the pursuit of artificial power. The Sith of Bane's line believed in the strength of the individual and valued most the power that came from within.
So overall, what's really more impressive? One whose powers come from their own knowledge and training, or one whose powers are gained through non-natural means? I say it's more impressive and practical to have natural power, and because of this, I give Palpatine the edge as a Force user. Now we compare armament and tools. Palpatine's main lightsaber followed a very artistic design and was even referred to by Darth Vader as an antique. It followed a very simple design with a smooth hilt and indentations on the sides signifying hand placement. Something that also made Palpatine's lightsaber stand out was instead of metal or chrome like most lightsabers, it instead sported an electrum finish. Electrum coating is the rarest finish one can have on a lightsaber, and only the most esteemed Jedi or Sith can possess it. However, electrum is purely cosmetic and doesn't change the blade's power or maneuverability in the slightest. Palpatine also had several other backup lightsabers at his disposal. Several tiny bits of treachery that he kept in reserve. These lightsabers featured identical designs to his main one, except with a slightly darker finish. All of Palpatine's weapons utilized a single red synthetic crystal as the focusing lens. Palpatine was also known for sometimes taking the lightsabers off the Jedi he killed personally and mounting them on his wall for use if his current weapons weren't accessible to him at the time, as he demonstrated with his fight with Luke Skywalker. Although Vitiate was not known for his dueling skills, he still kept a lightsaber on hand at all times. He appears to wield a standard Sith lightsaber that follows the typical archaic design of his era, with a long hilt and sharp edges at the end. This weapon utilized a single red synthetic crystal as the focusing lens. Overall, a good design, but nothing incredibly special, although I will give him credit for keeping with the times by using an actual lightsaber rather than those archaic Sith swords of his brethren. I would have to give Palpatine the edge in terms of armament and tools, as not only does he have more blades at his disposal, but they feature more complex and advanced designs than Vitiate's blade. But I will point out it is only a slight edge. And now we've reached the verdict. Essentially, this battle is like comparing the foundation of a building to the actual building itself. And this is the real issue with comparing Rule of Two Sith to the Ancient Sith. Every era of Sith in galactic history had their own unique qualities. There were the ancient sorcerers, the architects, the warriors, the butchers, the arrogant leaders, and then the Rule of Two. As Darth Bane said, the Force is not fire, the Force is venom. If it is poured into too many cups, it loses its potency until it becomes so diluted it is merely an irritant. Yet pour those cups back into a single vessel, and you will have the power to stop a great dragon's heart. He wasn't just referring to the amount of Sith, but what they knew. While the rule of two Sith were in hiding, they spent 1,000 years not only mastering the Jedi's abilities, but their own, encompassing every era and every ability into one solid, devastating line. And it was for those reasons that almost every rule of two Sith was on par with the absolute best of the Jedi Order. And Palpatine? Palpatine was the ultimate culmination of generations of Sith before him. In many ways, he was the dark side. And all those Sith after him, whether they liked to admit it or not, modeled their deeds in several ways after his. Vitiate, by contrast, in some ways, was the ultimate culmination of his era of sorcerers and alchemists in an insane quest for immortality. However, the issue with that is he didn't evolve to be anything more than that, and while he was extremely powerful, he was essentially a relic of an archaic age, and failed to remake himself, turning all his attention inward instead of outward. So I think Palpatine is the most definitive winner of this battle, as he outclasses Vitiate as both a duelist and a force user. I will say though, his victory would not be an easy one, and while he may come out victorious, he's going to come out of it exhausted, and at the very least with a broken rib or two. But with that said, I declare Palpatine, Dark Lord of the Sith, the winner. Well, there you go, guys. The Versus series request I've been getting since the beginning. I'm really glad you guys have been enjoying these videos, and I still have several Versus series episodes down the way, as well as a few special videos I'm planning on making, so stay tuned for those. Also, just to point out, even though I said those things about the rule of two, don't take that as I think every rule of two Sith could beat ancient Sith. I still think there are plenty of ancient Sith who could stand up to the rule of two era. So if you have an idea like that, don't be afraid to ask about it. I also want to thank GreyJedi91 for the audio he provided for this video, and as always, guys, keep it civil. This is just my opinion, no one else's. But with that said, I hope you guys enjoyed. Please leave suggestions for future Versus series or other videos in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys later.